Oh, you guys, I'm so excited to share something that God just opened my understanding to. I'm just blown away by the Lord. It's so profound yet so simple. Today is 6:20, 2022. And it was this morning just as I was taking care of my boys, and it was just like, God just opened my understanding. And some of you guys, he might have already revealed this to, but to me, I'm just blown away and I want to share it. It's so, so profound yet so simple. So, the bride of Christ and Jesus, this is what it pertains to. Just as a man and woman, when they get married, become one flesh, when the bride of Christ and Jesus Christ get married, we will become one. Just as a man and a woman, when they get married, they bring forth children, they give birth, they have children. I feel the Holy Spirit in this. When the bride of Christ and Jesus become one, we will bring forth children, spiritual birth, a people that shall be born. And the scriptures that pertain to it, I'll put it underneath. And one of them is, I believe it's in Isaiah. Again, I'll put it all, the scriptures below. And it talks about a people that shall be born. That's what Mary represented. Mary represented the five wise virgins. She represents the bride of Christ. Jesus represents being born again, giving birth. When the Holy Spirit came upon Mary, that represents the marriage of the bride of Christ and Jesus. When we become one, and we will give birth to a people that shall be born. We are going to be one. Do you guys understand how profound this is? How huge this is? The bride of Christ and Jesus are going to be married and be one. And give birth to a people that shall be born of the Holy Spirit fire. Of spiritual birth. Jesus says you must be born again. You must be born again. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the spirit is spirit. Marvel not. When he was talking to Nicodemus, that I said you must be born again. I'm blown away, you guys. It's so, so simple, but it's so profound. So when the bride of Christ and Jesus, oh, and another thing, a woman is pregnant for 40 weeks. It takes 40 weeks to create a baby. I believe this is going to be done in 40 days for a baby to be born, for this birth to happen. It's going to be in 40 days when the bride of Christ gets taken up. And it's not, I believe it's going to happen. The Lord has revealed this to me through his saints who he brought into my life to reveal this to me. This isn't my own. This is the Lord gave me this gift from other people that he has placed in my life to reveal these things to me. It's going to be 40 days. The bride of Christ, when we get taken, joined together with Jesus and return for 40 days. And at the end of 40 days, I believe a birth, the people that shall be born again will be born at once at the end of 40 days. I'm not entirely sure. Again, I'm going to pray more about this. I pray you guys take this to the Lord. But 40 is significant. Noah was in the ark. I believe it was 40 days. I'll have to look that up again. And then Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days. David and Goliath, the Goliath giant, they came every day for 40 days. And it was at the end of 40 days that David killed Goliath. Well, Jesus, the Lord God Almighty, killed Goliath through David. With a stone. The stone that the builders rejected. So anyways, the stone that's going to become a great mountain and fill the whole earth represents the kingdom of God, which is in us. And that's in the Bible. Again, I'm going to post all the scriptures below. The reason, and I know I'm going to have to post this later, is because I got a strike on my YouTube and I don't know how many more days. I think I might have 4 more days left. So I'll be posting this in like 4 days or so, give or take. I'll have to check. Anyways, you guys, profound, so simple, so glorious. All glory to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords for revealing these things to such base people. And Jesus even said, Father, I thank you that you have hid these things from the wise and prudent and revealed them unto babes, for so it seemed right in thy sight, or good in thy sight. That way he gets all the glory. Man can't boast any longer. It's for the Lord God Almighty and his Holy Spirit that reveals all things. Much studying is weariness, right? I'll post that scripture too. You know, people go to Bible college and they study and they get degrees, and it's kind of like the Holy Spirit is who teaches us all things and reveals all things. That's why he chose the 12 disciples. They weren't indoctrinated by man. They weren't, you know, they were empty vessels for him to use. They were unlearned men. Even the Pharisees and Sadducees marveled because they knew they were unlearned men. And they were like, how do they know all this stuff? That way God gets glorified. God is going to be glorified, him alone. No, man will not get his glory any longer, you guys. He put that so strongly on me to share. Man will not get his glory any longer. He alone will be exalted and made very high. And about the bride of Christ and Jesus becoming one. I am in my Father in me, and I in you, I believe. Again, I'll post all these scriptures below because I can't really recall it verbatim. So again, you guys, please read all the scriptures below that I post that goes along with this. Pray about it. Take it to the prayer closet. Take it to your private place with God. Let him reveal and confirm these things with you. Again, I don't know if I have it all right or together, but 40 days, 40, that 40, and 40 in the Strong's, I believe, means holy and sacred. Again, I will look that up. But you guys, I'm just so excited that the Lord has revealed this to me. Again, it's so just, God, you're amazing, God. Let's just take a moment to just realize how amazing our God is right now. Just, oh, wow, God. Thank you, Father. Oh, God, you're so glorious. Oh, his ways are so much higher, and it's for him to reveal mysteries by his Holy Spirit. Okay, you guys, I love you all, and I pray you guys have a blessed day.